Hey guys, so as you all know, Google just released the Tez app in India yesterday, which is a UPI-based payments app for India only. In this video today, I'm going to show you how the app works, what it does, and how you can set it up on your Android or your iPhone easily. Let's get started. Okay, so before we begin, some points to be clear out. Number one is that this is a UPI-based payment, so this is not a wallet kind of payment system like Paytm or FreeCharge that you get with all those apps. So this is a UPI-based payment which comes from the National Payments Corporation of India. So the bank transfers or the money transfers happen from the bank of person A to bank of person B directly without the help of any other wallet or any other third-party medium. Also, this is not an Android Pay replacement for India, so you do not need any specialized hardware on your phone like NFCs, etc. So it just works on any smartphone that has a microphone and an audio speaker output, which I guess all of these phones have today. So the Tez app is similar to the UPI apps that are already present in our country, namely PhonePay, Bheem, and other bank-based UPI apps that you have seen in all these months. So to get started with the Tez app, all you need is a basic smartphone with an internet connection, a bank account with whom you have verified your phone number.
So depending on what platform you are, go ahead and download the Tez app from the App Store or from the Play Store. So once you're done with installing the app, go ahead and open the Tez app over there. And as you can see, it asks for your phone number. Remember, on Android, it shows the language option first. However, on iOS, you directly go ahead and enter the phone number. So I'll just enter the phone number outside the camera and hit on next. And next, it'll ask you whether you can send notifications. So after you have chosen your Google account, it will just send you an OTP on your phone, which you can just enter and we'll proceed. So added protection for Tez, so we'll just create a Google PIN or so we'll just enter any random number, so 9633. Okay, so 9633. So once you're set up with Google PIN, it will just ask to unlock your phone with Touch ID. So if you are on an Android phone and if you have a fingerprint, it will ask for you the same over there. So as you can see, now we are inside the Tez app and it just shows you a quick preview of all the features and we'll just allow it location access. So the first option that you get on your Tez app is the tap for cash mode. So this uses your phone speaker and microphone to send payments to your nearby devices. So you can just click on the Tez icon and you can just hit on allow access for microphone. The same option would also come up on an Android device. So you can push it up to pay to someone, okay? And if you can alternatively put it down for receiving payments for someone. So in both case, it will just start detecting for other devices that are around. So it has to be a Tez app or a device with running on a Tez app. So next we'll just swipe up and as you can see, there are two options where it shows all transactions, where it will show up all the transactions that you make through the Google Tez app. And also there are the cash mode transactions, which shows you the list of transactions that you have done on cash mode. So as you can see on the top, we have an option called the add bank account. So you can choose your bank. So I have an Axis Bank account, so I'll just add Axis Bank. Okay, so. And as you can see, it says add bank account, so it will send an SMS to the phone. So this is why it is important that you set up the app only where you have the SIM installed or which is registered with your bank. So it will just send a normal SMS, so that might take up some operator charge depending on what plan you are on. As you can see, it has found out the Axis Bank account that I have that is already registered with UPI via the PhonePe app, which I have been using for a long time now, as I mentioned before. So it is asking me for my UPI PIN. So if you are the first time user for UPI, the option will show you to enter a new UPI PIN for this account. So since I am already registered with the UPI process, I'll just enter my UPI PIN. So as you can see, it verified my UPI PIN and now you can see my account is added. So anytime now I can send and receive payments from. So once you have set up your bank account, go ahead and click on that new icon. So this will start a payment option. And if the other person is also using a Tez account or a Tez app on their phone, you can just enter their Tez phone number and directly send the payment to them. However, if they are using a different UPI app, you can enter their account number over here, the recipient's name, the account number, and the IFSC code of that bank account or wherever the account is situated. And you can also send a payment out that way. So you can also enter the UPI ID, which might be an email address or their phone number, whatever they have set up with any other UPI app. You can also scan the QR code on any other UPI app or on the Tez app itself, or you can also go ahead and enter their phone number if they're using a Tez app.
So that's pretty much how you set up the app and get started using it and transferring money to your friends and family. So yeah, it's free and all the transactions on the app are also free. However, there are several other UPI-based apps already present in India. The big names including Bheem that comes directly from the government of India, and also the PhonePe app which comes from the Flipkart family. So if you have been using any of these apps, it will be pretty much the same. So I still kind of like PhonePe because of all the tie-ups it has with all the electricity bill payment companies, etc. So if Google ends up with a lot more partnerships than PhonePe does, I'll definitely would consider shifting to PhonePe, but right now PhonePe is my choice of UPI app. So if you haven't checked out PhonePe yet, the link for that is down in the description below, as well as the link for the Google Play Store and App Store for Tez app is also down in the description below. So that's it for this video. Do let me know down in the comments below whether you use a UPI app or whether you will be using Tez, or whether you have already been using another UPI app like PhonePe or Bheem, as I mentioned. Thank you guys for staying till the end of this video, and if you have any other comments and thoughts and suggestions, don't forget to leave them down in the comments below. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button, and if you would like to see more videos of this kind, consider subscribing. The next videos that I'm pushing out on Thursday and Saturday would be the videos on iOS 11 on iPhone 5S and iPad mini 3, so if you're interested in that, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.